This is an FRG ministry production with the support of our ministry partners and donors.
It's the fourth Sunday of Advent, and we're about to celebrate Mass together. This is a time for us to stop amongst the busyness of life, the busyness of preparing for Christmas, to stop and allow the Lord to speak to our hearts. We need His strength to be able to survive this week, to be able to have the strength to do all that God asks of us, especially to be His presence in the world. On behalf of FRG Ministry, thank you so much for joining us, for tuning into this Mass. I pray that you will pray. Don't just watch, put your coffees down, put your biscuits down, and just stop and pray. Immerse yourself in this Mass. If you're able to support this ministry in any way, please go to frgministry.com/donate. We depend so much on what you are able to give, big or small. So together, let us celebrate this Holy Eucharist in preparation for the fourth week of Advent.
The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries and trembles at His voice, trembles at His voice. How great is our God, sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, see how great is our God. And time is in His hands, beginning and the end, beginning and the end. The Godhead three in one, Father, Spirit, and Son, the Lion and the Lamb, the Lion and the Lamb. Yeah, how great.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. We are in the fourth Sunday of Advent, a beautiful time of prayer. And those of you who are joining us for the Advent retreat, welcome as we continue our journey seeking the Lord and choosing Him above all things. You know, next week, as we celebrate Christmas, prepare your heart. This is the last moment just to, in the rush of things, just to let go and to trust in the Lord. Lord, I want this Christmas to be about You and not about the things around me. So Lord, as I come to You, I ask for mercy for the times I got distracted. Lord, have mercy. For those times I put entertainment and the comfort of others before my relationship with You, Christ, have mercy. And for those times, Lord, even during this Advent season and Christmas, I have forgotten the poor. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Pour forth, we ask you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of the resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the second book of Samuel. Your house and your sovereignty will always stand secure before me. Once David had settled into his house, and the Lord had given him rest from all the enemies surrounding him, the king said to prophet Nathan, "Look, I am living in a house of cedar, while the ark of God dwells in a tent." Nathan said to the king, "Go and do all that is in your mind, for the Lord is with you." And that very night the word of the Lord came to Nathan, "Go and tell my servant David, thus the Lord speaks, are you the man to build me a house to dwell in? I took you from the pasture, from following the sheep, to be a leader of my people Israel. I have been with you on all your expeditions. I have cut off all your enemies before you. I will give you fame, as great as the fame of the greatest on earth. I will provide a place for my people Israel. I will plant them there, and they shall dwell in that place and never be disturbed again. Nor shall the wicked continue to oppress them as they did in the days when I appointed judges over my people Israel. I will give them rest from all their enemies. The Lord will make you great. The Lord will make you a house. And when your days are ended and you are laid to rest with your ancestors, I will preserve your offspring of your body after you and make his sovereignty secure. I will be a father to him and he a son to me. If he does evil, I will punish him with a rod such as men use, with strokes such as mankind gives. Your house and your sovereignty will always stand secure before me, and your throne will be established forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let your response be, "Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord."
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
I will sing forever of your love, O Lord. Through all my ages, my mouth will proclaim your truth. For this I am sure, that your love lasts forever, that your truth is firmly established as the heavens.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant, I will establish your dynasty forever and set up your throne through all ages.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
He will say to me, "You are my Father, my God, the rock who saves me. I will keep my love for him always, and with him my covenant shall last."
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
The second reading, a reading from the book of Romans. The mystery is revealed that was kept secret for endless ages. Glory to him who is able to give you the strength to live according to the good news I preach, and in which I proclaim Jesus Christ, the revelation of a mystery kept secret for endless ages, but now so clear that it must be broadcast to pagans everywhere to bring them to the obedience of faith. This is only what Scripture has predicted, and it is all a part of the way the eternal God wants things to be. He alone is wisdom. Give glory, therefore, to Him through Jesus Christ forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. I am the servant of the Lord. May His will for me be done. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came to Mary and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will be there forever." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her who was to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be done with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. Mary. I love how Mary trusted the Lord. She had this encounter with angel Gabriel. An angel is someone who's a messenger of the Lord. She had, in a sense, an encounter with God the Father. And in that encounter, she was given an incredible mission to bring Jesus to this world. This is the same mission that you and I have. At 16, 17 years old, I had an incredible encounter with the Lord. And this encounter changed my life, and I experienced the love of God. I write about this in my book, Breakthrough. I'm not going to go through all of the detail, but I had such an intense encounter that I ran. I ran across the world to tell anyone I could about what Jesus did in my life. And I see this in Mary. You know, she goes out, she experiences this love of God, this encounter with God, and she runs out to Elizabeth. She doesn't keep it to herself. She doesn't enjoy and bask in the presence of God, which is something beautiful, something wonderful, but she goes out. But the thing that the gospel finishes with, it says this: the angel left her. That moment of consolation where she fell to the presence of God, where she was able to say yes, all of a sudden is not present anymore. And she goes, and it's tiresome. She has to walk, she runs, she walks towards Elizabeth. It's not a short walk. It was a day, 2 days walk. It was crazy. I don't know if you've ever been to the Church of the Visitation where Elizabeth lived, but it's an incredible hill, a long way up. Many people are not able to walk up that hill. There's a taxi service that takes you up and down this hill. It's crazy. And Mary walked this up pregnant. Now, this is her heart, you see, because when we encounter the Lord, we cannot keep it to ourselves. We want to reach out to others. Even in moments where we don't feel the presence of God, where we don't sense the closeness of God. I also experienced the love of God intensely when I was 17, but for almost 10 years, 15 years after, not a single moment of consolation. But the passion was still there. The desire to serve the Lord was still there. I wanted above all things to make a mark in the kingdom of God because I wanted people to experience what I experienced. I wanted the world to know what Jesus had done in my life, that he transformed me from an addict to someone who wants to build the kingdom of God. What about us? Sometimes we wish we could feel the presence of God, and maybe in the past we have experienced closeness to God, but now God seems far away. But even though God seems far away, his call for you to reach out to others, as Mary did to Elizabeth, has not stopped. God's call over your life to serve others does not stop with the feelings. Continue to love, continue to serve. Continue to choose the Lord. Continue to walk with the Lord. Continue to say yes to God, even when the angel leaves, even when the presence of God isn't present and it's just hard work. God is there. God is present. As we approach this Christmas day, let's ask the Lord, Lord, let me, like Elizabeth, say yes to you. And even these moments of consolation, when we can hold the baby Jesus in our hands, those moments where we feel your presence, let us be grateful, but not dependent on these moments of consolation. We want to serve you even when the feelings are not there. Let us now proclaim our faith. If you're able to stand, let us stand as a gesture of proclamation of what we believe in. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. What are you going to pray for? What's your intention for this Mass? Well, I'd like to start by praying for the poor, for those who are in need of God's mercy and God's presence in their life. Bring, Lord, their consolation. And if it is your will, let it be through us. Lord, hear us. We pray for the church, that the church may stand in truth, even if the world hates us for it. Lord, hear us. Just now bring your own prayers to the Lord, maybe with your family out loud or in the silence of your own heart. As Mary brought about the prayers and the presence of God to the world, let us pray that she will continue to carry out this mission in our lives. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, to become for us the bread of life.
How I need you. Where sin runs deep, your grace is more. Where grace is found is where you are.
God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, the fruit of the vine and work of human hands, has become our spiritual drink.
My righteousness, oh God, how I need you. You're my one defense, my righteousness.
So pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of the Nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in praise. And so with the angels and archangels, with the thrones and dominions, and with the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it. Then he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with Shane, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face and have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
I need you.
worship you until the very end. Jesus, lover of my soul. Jesus, I will never let you go.
Pray for you that the Holy Spirit may work in your life, especially during this busy time. I know for some you're approaching this week with great joy, but others with dread as well. You're terrified, maybe you've lost someone you love. It's a difficult time for you. And I want to pray for every person who's praying with us. So Father God, I thank you that you know the heart of every person, those who are joy-filled and those who are scared and lonely. Father God, I just pray that you send your Holy Spirit upon them. Give them the peace that only you can give, the joy that only you can bring, the strength that is only found in you. So God, I just ask that they may have an open heart to receive your presence right here, right now, and bring them this beautiful gift of consolation, your embrace. Lord, I ask you to look after those who are grieving, who are sad, those in nursing homes and prisons, those who are in places like hospitals. Lord, give them your comfort and your peace. Those who have a feeling that the world has abandoned them, let them know, Lord Jesus, that you will never, ever leave them or forsake them. Lord, I thank you that you healing someone of a neck pain. And there's someone also, there's a fungus on the foot. Lord, thank you that you're healing someone here and now. You are an awesome God, and we love you, and we thank you. Together, let us pray an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. On behalf of FRG Ministry, we thank you for praying with us. We have some wonderful things going on at the moment, like the Advent retreat. If you'd still like to join, please go to frgministry.com/events. Also, the Christmas liturgies and devotions, that will all be broadcast for you as well at frgministry.com/mass. I hope you'll be able, even at least this Christmas broadcast will be with zero views because we'll all be at Mass. But for those who cannot make it, please join us for this Holy Mass as we'll be praying for you. If you're able to support this ministry in any way or any form, please go to frgministry.com/donate. We depend on you, your generosity. We cannot run this ministry without you, especially during this time at the end of the year. We always struggle financially as a ministry, as our expenses are so high. So please prayerfully consider any donation that you're able to give to this ministry. Let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you, and may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains. Unending love, amazing grace. T'was grace that taught my heart to feel, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the hour I first believed. My chains are gone,
production is only made possible because of the generous support of FRG Ministry partners and donors. Please go to frgministry.com/donate to make a donation.
Over the last few months, FRG Ministry has partnered with an incredible ministry called Talita Kumi. These are based in Vijayawada in India, here right where I am. An incredible ministry because they reach out to young girls who are stuck in sex trafficking. Without them, there's no hope for them to get out of this horrible lifestyle and this livelihood, which is because their families, their parents cannot afford to keep them. So they're sold for a few rupees to people who use them and abuse them. FRG Ministry also has partnered with them to give the formation to the 750 nuns that work with them. But also we're partnering in helping these young girls and reaching out to them and giving them hope and the dignity that they deserve.
We are so grateful of this partnership. We're so thankful that we can get to do this. And we're going to be coming to India at least once a year to reach out to these young girls and to the nuns. We ask you to pray for us, but also we ask you to support this ministry. We'll put a link below if you're able to support us. God is working powerfully, and we need to reach out to those who are being abused, those who are lost, and those who have lost their dignity. You can make a difference. We can make a difference. We do what we can, but we can only do it if you do what you can. God bless you, and also please remember to pray for both of our ministries.
Encounter Youth by FRG Ministry presents our new and exciting course, The Synoptic Gospels. Join Alyssa Aegis and Justine Cumbo from the Catholic Influencers Podcast as they journey through the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke in this curriculum-based online course. This course aims to deepen participants' understandings of the Gospel teachings, emphasizing their relevance in the Catholic tradition and their application to personal prayer life. With state-of-the-art video production, teacher and student PDFs, lesson plans, class activities, and more, consider using this resource for your classroom or youth group today. You can access this resource and our entire Encounter course library at encountercourses.com/subscription.